to just ask you a few questions about your work and why you are where you are today and your work with clients and with corporations. And I'd like to start back at kind of at the beginning and ask you, I noticed in looking at your website that there's a lot of information in it about language and languaging and how that impacts people and their lives. So I thought it would be nice if you could give everyone a sense of your history and why that has actually been so instrumental in the work you do today.
Oh, good. Thanks for asking that question. As far back as I can remember when I was a little kid, it always fascinated me, excuse me, is how some people could talk and say things and the whole room would light up. People would get excited and do that. And that those people always seemed to be successful or productive in what they were doing. And it wasn't so much about what the words they were using, but it was like the way they were speaking and how they were listening to everybody and the questions that people asked and how they answered them. And it really sort of stuck with me that it was really about language. If we call language anything that impacts us in a way that has something to do with the present moment of our thinking, it's really all about language. And that people, I noticed over the years, who are comfortable and aware of that phenomena in themselves, have a way of being in the world that, one, attracts people to be around them, and two, allows them to live a really sort of peaceful life, but very successful also. Some of the most successful people I know have that quality about them, about being able to be present and listening in a way that lets the world sort of reward them for what they're doing. So I started in college, I studied interpersonal mass media communication and I majored in that. And that included, it was very cute, that included some of the courses of nonverbal communication. I did a whole 400 series of nonverbal communication classes where I'd go to the airport and I would film people greeting people or saying goodbye to people on flights. And it went through a whole bunch of different types of hello goodbyes. You know, you had one nonverbal hello where the people were really genuinely excited about saying hello to each other. And they would kiss and they would hold on and that would give them the experience of hello, hello. And I would call that hello, hello. And then there it goes and it sort of progresses like hello and oh, hi. You know, the dance goes on. And then there would be, when they were saying goodbye to each other, the other one that was very funny, I thought, with people was when someone would be leaving and you'd see them hug goodbye and see one of them say goodbye and the other one goes, phew, goodbye. So we had all this nonverbal stuff. The interesting thing about it was what it really meant is whatever I thought it meant or whatever the people in the room had some story about what it meant. And so as I continued to go through and investigate language and how it impacts us in our daily life, I also started to do some transformational work way back in the early 70s. And really sort of seminal work with the opening of transformation with the Earhart programs and other programs like that. And what I noticed was it was always around people's inner conversations with themselves and the way they interpreted themselves in our world, in our daily world. So probably the most impactful and powerful moment of my learning was when I got to work with Dr. Fernando Flores, who brought into existence the whole communication for action concept, that when you speak, it generates actions always, not sometimes, but always. And people are blind to that to some degree in their lives. And then when you sort of can step back from that and start to see how you're speaking and how you're listening to what you're saying and what other people are saying to you, start to generate the actions in your life that has your life look like it is. And when I started to discover that, I started to see different ways to coach people and ask them questions that allowed them to become what I call, for lack of a better word, a new observer of their own life and their own being in the world. And when people start to have that experience of seeing the phenomena of how language shapes the way the world occurs to them and how the way they listen to the stories in the back of their head shape the way the world occurs to them, and they get a bigger look at that, they can really start to step back and relax and say, wait a second, there's got to be more than this.